Well, we all know it. The heat is on, and while you may be thinking about how to keep yourself cool, you better not forget about your little furry friends. Dr. Katy Nelson is back, and she brought a couple of her own furry friends with her. Too cute. Good morning.
Good morning.
Who do we have with us this morning?
We have guinea pigs and parakeets. There is a humongous number of these guys at the Alexandria shelter right now looking for homes. I believe there are 16 guinea pigs and 17 parakeets.
And why?
Well, what our theory is that the movie G-Force came out.
Okay.
Lots of people's kids went to see G-Force, and they said, "Oh, Mom, I want a guinea pig, I want a guinea pig," and so they all went and got a guinea pig. And then a few months later, the shine has worn off.
It's the Finding Nemo syndrome.
Yeah, and people kind of didn't really realize that if you put a male and a female guinea pig together,
Things might happen.
These guys actually are from a litter of five that is exactly from that reason. And so I brought four. I brought the four brothers because the sisters being housed separately.
Good idea.
For obvious reasons. But these guys are all named after cheese, and I think it's precious. Gouda, provolone, pepperjack, and Munster, and Gruyere is being held at the shelter on her own.
And who is this?
I have no idea.
You have no idea.
I have no clue.
Well, at least you're honest about it.
Yeah, I have no clue. Let's say it's pepperjack.
Done. All right. So, is there a specific heat warning for these guys compared to dogs and cats?
Well, I mean, these guys are pretty much going to be indoor pets. So, you know, they're not really going to suffer as much from the heat as potentially our dogs or even our cats are going to. So, I'm an emergency veterinarian, and I have seen far too many heat strokes this year. And I mean, people think when your dog gets overheated, you know, let's cool him off and then, you know, he should be okay.
Yeah.
But I mean, we've had people that have had to leave their pets in the hospital for days and days and days because they can develop clotting abnormalities. They can have GI issues. They can have cardiac arrhythmias. They can go into liver failure or kidney failure from overheating.
And how long does it take for that to set in?
Not very long at all.
That's
I mean, the most recent one was a dog that had been a runner for quite a while, and but they hadn't run him in a few months. And one morning, they decided they needed to get him back out there and start running again because he was getting a little chunky, and took him out for a run. And within about the first 15 minutes of the run, he fell over and was in the hospital for about 4 days, had to have a couple of blood transfusions, you know, and that's about 10 grand later.
Sure.
They finally got to take their dog home, but we weren't sure that their dog was going to live through it.
And he is doing better?
He's doing okay.
Well, that's good.
He's doing okay.
What are the signs to look for?
Well, so first off, my biggest thing would be to, you know, just know your dog and know what your dog can do. If you have an overweight dog, if you have a dog with a really thick hair coat, let's just not do that. Let's just not take them out for a run. You know, take them to doggy daycare. Let them go play in the air conditioning, and, you know, do it safely for them. The things to watch for are, you know, a dog's going to pant when they get hot. But if they're panting and they just kind of can't control themselves, if they have a change in mentation, they're going
nuts. Are
they
fighting? What's going on in there?
They're making all sorts of guinea pig noises.
Get the overhead camera in here. It's a brawl.
It's a mob scene in there.
They're hot.
That's right. But if you look at their gums, and instead of their gums being nice and pink, if they're white or if they're bright, bright red, that's a sign something's wrong. We need to get them in. If your dog can't stand up, if it's weak, if it's stumbly, I mean, this is not a situation to ever be taken lightly. It's not one where you go, let me see how he does, and if he's not okay in the next half an hour, I'll take him in. This is something, if you see this happening in your dog, get them to your veterinarian immediately, because it really is dependent on how quickly we can institute therapy as to how they respond.
All right, so you're starting to see these symptoms, and you're thinking about going to the hospital. What can you do in the meantime to kind of help them?
In the meantime, get cool water, not cold water, not ice water, cool water, like from a water hose or just the regular cold water on your sink, and pour it on your dog. Cool towels. You can even take alcohol and put it on their foot pads and on the inner part of their ears, because that's some of the only hairless spots that they have to dissipate heat. So, you know, just try to do cooling, but not, you know, temperature crashing type of therapy on them. But the main thing is if you think this is happening to your dog, get them there immediately. Because, I mean, the longer you delay, the more problems they are potentially going to have.
We talk a lot about dogs, but is it different for cats? And what else would we have?
farm animals, things like that. Yeah, you know, I mean, farm animals in general aren't going to be out in the middle of the day running because they're not forced to on a leash. Mm-hmm. You know, I mean, these guys are going to go in the shade and things like that. Our cats are in general not going to be forced to go out and do this type of exercise as well. Cats are excellent at finding, you know, a cool dark spot to go into in the heat of the day and go out in the evening and the mornings if your cat has to be outside. Okay. That's the thing. In this area, it's really not a smart idea to have an outside cat because we have too many cars, too many dogs, too many other areas where these guys could potentially get in trouble. But if they have to be outside, they're usually pretty adept at finding a cool spot.
And cats, they kind of take care of themselves. They know.
Yeah, they're pretty independent.
Yeah, we have to watch out for our dogs.
Yeah.
All right, well, thank you very much. And we can adopt these guys?
Yes, absolutely. Please call the Alexandria Shelter or you can go to the shelter website, which is alexandriaanimals.org. And the G-Force movie is coming out on DVD. So everyone, if your kid is bugging you for a guinea pig, please go to the shelter. Don't go buy one.
And get more than one of them and you'll have a show.
Absolutely. But just get two boys or two girls.
Good advice. Always with the good advice. Thank you very much.
Thanks. Come